Now, ladies and gentlemen, here's one you all can sing with us when the Saints go marching in.
Don't ever worry about what you're going to play. Just remember, there's no such thing as a wrong note. What makes a note wrong is when you don't know where to go after that one. Hart Tatum. All music has a foundation in invention. But above all else, jazz is known for improvisation. But its innovation would go beyond that. It would change the world around it. It would attract listeners and fans from all races, and would put black and white musicians playing side by side. It would change the way people viewed race, and would help change the racial boundaries that were dividing America. The origins of jazz remain obscure. What is known is that it was on the American slave plantations that the earliest roots of what would become jazz were formed. For entertainment, slaves created the improvisational form of music that would evolve into what we call jazz after it was mixed with other elements.
Well, you got to remember it was a combination of factors. You had the West African influence coming into southern United States with the slave population growing. And so they heard our music, they heard from our standpoint was harmony with the church music, the Protestant church music in the South, and missionaries and what have you. And so they heard these hymns that were in basic chords, and I'll play them for you. So they heard this a lot, and those three chords gradually went into what we call the blues.
Jazz was first formed and became popular in New Orleans, but eventually it would expand north, moving first to Chicago, then to New York, and eventually throughout the world. Jazz was the first music that was made popular by black musicians to expand to an audience beyond racial barriers. It was accepted and listened to by almost every social and racial group. The unique part of this is that whites were mainly seeking entertainment from African Americans.
These were black musicians, and there were some white musicians who connected with it early on. And there was a group called the Original Dixieland Band, and they were all white guys. Well, that was about as original as pigs flying or whatever. It was a commercial reproduction. They were all good players, and they assimilated the style of what the black musicians were playing. But essentially, it was a black music to begin with in its inception.
As time went on, however, jazz began to not only be listened to by other races, but it would begin to be played by them.
Well, at first, some might have thought, well, jazz is the music of the Negro, of the colored people. At first they may have thought this, but that no longer is the case. Jazz is found in all racial groups. The Latin, the American, the white, it's played by all racial groups.
Jazz was not only being played cross-racially, but the different races would even play together. For the first time, black and white musicians would play side by side.
Jazz was one of the first, the non-segregated way of playing, because if you were a jazz musician and you could play, you were welcome to be in a white band and vice versa. So there wasn't this color line in jazz early on. Everybody else had the color line going, but not in jazz music. Because if you were a musician first, a jazz musician, you were accepted readily, then you went from there.
Racism, however, was still a major issue, and offstage the black musicians were not treated equally. Because of this, change was slow, but it did start a shift that would grow over time.
There was acceptance in music and jazz of the black musicians in a white culture, gradually, very gradually. But, for example, there was a singer named Billie Holiday. She had very light skin, but she was a black person, obviously intermarried back somewhere. Baltimore is where she came from originally, and So there was a mixture in the racial background. But she could pass for white. Now, when she would get with certain bands, she sang with Artie Shaw's big band. When they went down south, one way or another, they would find out that she was black. And so they would say, well, this is fine, your band can play here, but she can't sing with the band. Or, okay, you can sing, but she can't stay in the same hotel. She's got to go to another hotel. So this kind of thing pervaded the situation until we really got into the 50s and things began to gradually change.
Even though the cross-racial nature of jazz did not cause an immediate change in the racial boundaries in America, it did cause a shift that would help in a change over time. Another and more long-term factor in the racial changes made by jazz was its way of allowing blacks entry into popular culture. Jazz acted as a gateway that opened up the opportunity for blacks to form future styles of music, as well as for them to be put into popular films.
It took a long while for a black actor to get from an all-black cast, which they did in the early years of Hollywood, the late 20s, early 30s, into mixing black people into the white movies. Now, there were black people as actors, but what were they doing? They were the hired help, the whatever, or they were the comical person in a white movie situation. But by the 50s, you had these black actors who, Sidney Poitier, for example, and many others, who gradually crossed that color line and were accepted.
Due to their popularity, many African Americans would be viewed higher by whites. But the popularity would also allow them to move up in society. Many black Americans are poor and working low-end jobs. Some would have the opportunity to work in factories, but even then they were treated with inequality and usually paid less. They had few ways to escape this life since segregation laws restricted the quality of education a black person could get. But after the birth of jazz, blacks finally had a place in popular culture. This, among other factors, helped many to no longer be restrained to the same lifestyle. In fact, some black people would even become wealthy. As big band leader Duke Ellington said in reference to Louis Armstrong, he was born poor, died rich, and never hurt anyone along the way. It can be argued that Louis Armstrong foreshadowed the movement of blacks into popular culture. He started out as an instrumental jazz player, then he became a singer performing music that was not limited to jazz, and he would even act in some films. Although no one but him would do all of these things, blacks as a whole would move into popular culture in this same pattern. Once blacks worked their way into popular culture, they were able to influence forms of music other than jazz. Perhaps the biggest of these forms are rock and roll, rhythm and blues, hip-hop, and rap. Each helped give blacks a platform to express their beliefs and ideas. In the time of the blues, these messages were communicated subtly, within the music. But as time progressed, these messages were expressed more straightforward. In the 1980s, political hip-hop was introduced. Black musicians used the music as a medium for expressing their feeling of oppression. But unlike the messages in the blues, these expressions were not hidden. They were obvious. Perhaps one of the most prominent of these songs is the 1989 hit Fight the Power by rap group Public Enemy. The song clearly expresses that racism still existed in a post-Civil Rights Act America. Even though the majority of current rap songs are not nearly as political as the ones from the 80s and early 90s, rap artists still use their popularity as a platform to communicate their political beliefs. Jazz was innovative in multiple ways. It was new and different in its beginnings. Its improvisational nature also makes it a constant innovation when being played. In addition, jazz was innovative racially, acting as a factor in the shift of racial boundaries. Although we still have a long way to go, we have come a long way racially in the last 100 years, with much thanks to jazz. Will I run the rock? Please hide me around the rock. Please hide me around the rock. Please hide me, Lord. All on the day, but the rock cried out, I can't hide you, the rock cried out, I can't hide you, the rock cried out.